The spiritual layer is located between the paper and the paint applied by the artist.
Евгений Козлов.
So this is a great exhibition, Maximilianus. How did you select this series of drawings by Evgeny Kozlov, the Leningrad album for Ostalgia?
Well, it's a piece I saw in book form in, I think, 2005 or 2004 in Berlin, as we were doing research for the Berlin Biennale. It was recommended to us by Christoph Bannert, right, his name is, and we saw the book and he stayed with me and I kept looking at it. We thought a lot about putting it in the show at the time, but at the same time the atmospheres of the show were quite different. But it's such a powerful, beautiful thing that I kept thinking and thinking and thinking. And then we included it in another book, so it was always there. And then when I started thinking of this show, which I was also thinking in the last 2-3 years, I thought that it would have been one of the cornerstones, literally, and one of the foundations of the show to have this piece. And for a few reasons, not only because I think it's beautiful, but because I think indirectly it speaks about desire, it speaks about desire, clearly erotic desire, but it speaks also about desires in a larger sense. And this show is a lot about desires and fantasies. You know, there is the fantasy of the communist ideology and myth, the dream that the world can be changed, and then there is the fantasies of people that were living there. There were fantasies to escape their life, and then there are the erotic fantasies of Evgeny, and so it's beautifully drawn, it's beautifully realized, but it's also so clearly a sort of desiring machine. You look at it and you can imagine the fantasies of a 14-15 year old, and it's also encyclopedic, which is beautiful because it's not desiring just sex, it's desiring an entire universe, which I think is very interesting. I also love some details, you know, the obsession with the ice skates, the obsession with the heaters. I find that very fascinating and immediately makes you think of Leningrad because it must be a cold place, because the heaters are always very present and the space heaters are also very present. Then there is the obsession with the furniture, the armchair, the chairs, the tables. So it's, I don't know, it's one of those pieces that you really feel like you're entering in the head of an individual, and that's a beautiful place to be, I think. And so that's why it was really a starting point. And the idea was maybe to show it completely, and it's quite complicated because it takes time and so on, but this is a presentation of 150 pages, I think, and it's also quite quite intense, I think, and people really, really like it, so I'm very proud that we brought it. You know, it's not in Berlin, but I'm proud.
Why is it not going? Now it's going.
Okay, so I start again. You asked me why I included this.
Yes.
So I'll start again. I saw the Leningrad album in book form, not the originals, probably back in 2004 or 2005 in Berlin. At the time I was curating the Berlin Biennale and I was doing research, and Christoph Bannert, this artist, with whom we had a great meeting, and he showed us these drawings, and I was very taken by them, and for a long time, for many years, I kept the book. I went back looking at it. It's one of those things that really stuck in my memory. For a long time, we also thought to put it in the Berlin Biennale, but then the atmospheres of the Berlin Biennale were very different, so it didn't really fit. But it was one of these works that I carried with me for many years. And then when I started thinking of a show, let's say about art and life in the former Soviet bloc, I went back to this piece and decided literally that I wanted it to be a cornerstone and a foundation for the exhibition. And so first of all, the idea was, if possible, even to show it all. We couldn't because it's quite expensive and they're very large, and so we decided to go for 150 pages, which is still a very, very strong presentation. And the reason why it's in the show is, of course, not only because it was made in Leningrad, but because I think it's a piece that speaks, indirectly speaks about life and everyday life also, and details in the girls' dresses. They have the ice skate, and there are like space heaters. There is a picture in which the man is dressed like a young pioneer, and so there are all these details that are revealing also of everyday life in the former Soviet Union. But most importantly, it's a piece that talks about desire, and of course there is the desire of the sexual desire, the erotic desire, which is the most obvious, but it's also, I think it's a desire to invent a universe and to escape a reality by inventing another one. And we were looking at it yesterday with some of the Russian artists in the show, and they were saying, oh, you could be arrested for this kind of work, particularly with the pioneer and so on. And I think it's also beautiful that, you know, Evgeny was closed in his room. That's how I imagine him, and drawing away this this parallel reality. So in a way it fits in the show because it's sort of a gigantic desire machine. It's a machine to make you desire and a machine to make you dream of a different world. It's also a piece that I think talks about passing time, and that's another theme throughout the show. You know, the artist that passes time and that maybe at home invents a different dimension of time, and sort of middle class way to think of art as a job. This piece and other pieces in the show talk about is how the artist and how humans spend time, and how time spends humans. and that's of course one of the themes of the show, that it's called Nostalgia, so it deals with time, and it deals with passing and representing time. So that was another reason why I really wanted the piece in the show.
Would you imagine that the whole album could be shown or should be shown?
I think, you know, it would be great. It's on this size is also quite substantial, so I'm very happy of it. You know, I certainly didn't want to show like 10 or 12. You know, I wanted to feel like it's going in the head of a person, and this is quite beautiful for that. And you see the dates, the it's years and years of work, and I think that's also quite fascinating.
Okay, Massimiliano, let me thank you.
I hope you're happy that it's in the show.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Is that okay? Or do you want more?
Thank you.
I hope you're happy that it's in the show.
Very much so.